In this section, I'm going to introduce you to the Esri Network Analyst Public Transit Data Model. Because data in this format is used as input to some of the other tools this video series talks about, this video provides important background information. I'll talk about what the data model is and how to get your data into this format. The Esri Network Analyst Public Transit Data Model is a set of feature classes and tables with specific schemas and specific relationships that defines the transit system's stops, lines, and schedules. It's similar to GTFS, but it's not the same. This is a data model that Esri created for use with some of our tools. Why is this data model important? This is the format we require for public transit schedule data for use in the Calculate Transit Service Frequency tool and for creating transit-enabled network datasets. Those are network datasets that can use the public transit schedules to model passengers traveling by public transit. Both of these are things that we'll be talking about in this video series, so you will definitely need to know about this data model. The public transit data model consists of a few feature classes for modeling the locations and characteristics of public transit stops and how they connect to streets, some feature classes and tables for modeling transit lines, and some tables for modeling the schedules. I'll go over these quickly here. If you want to learn about each of these in detail, I refer you to the documentation, which is linked from the slide. There are three feature classes that model the locations and characteristics of transit stops and their connections to streets. The stops feature class is very similar to GTFS stops. The geometry is the latitude and longitude of the stops, and it has various fields with stop characteristics, such as an ID relating it to the other tables, the type of the stop or station, and a field indicating whether it's wheelchair accessible. Stops on streets and stop connectors are used to relate the location of stops to the location of street features and maintain proper connectivity when building a network dataset. This helps you model pedestrians traveling by public transit and ensures that pedestrians can only transition between the streets and the transit lines at designated stop locations. Typically, the stop locations are offset a little from the street center lines, which is actually a good thing because it makes it easier to model connectivity. Stops on streets is a copy of the stops snapped to the nearest street location, and stop connectors is a line feature class providing a little connector between the stop location and where it snapped to the streets. You can use these little connectors to model a time delay for boarding or exiting transit vehicles and walking through large stations. Transit lines are modeled using a couple of related tables. The geographic component is called line variant elements. This feature class has line segments representing direct connections between stops. The line variants and lines tables are related tables that hold some additional characteristics about the transit lines, such as what type of transit is, like a bus or a subway, and also relate to the schedule tables. The line characteristics are abstracted to these tables so they can be shared and not repeated for each line variant elements feature. It's done this way for more efficient data storage. Let me review the geographic components again because it can be a little confusing. Streets aren't part of the data model, but if you're going to create a transit-enabled network dataset, you'll need them. You can see the streets in the little map here in gray. Transit lines are the line variant elements feature class. Those are the blue lines shown here. Line variant elements joins two stops, and the stops are usually offset from the street center line. Stops on streets is a copy of the stops snapped to the street feature. And stop connectors is a little line, little straight line, connecting the original stop location with the stops on streets snapped location. Okay, back to the remainder of the data model. There are several tables defining the public transit schedules. Calendars and calendar exceptions are almost directly equivalent to the calendar.txt and calendar.dates.txt files from GTFS. They define the days of the week, date ranges, and specific dates on which public transit service is running. Calendars defines regularly repeating service on weekdays. Calendar exceptions defines exceptions to the service, such as service added or subtracted for holidays. Schedules and schedule elements define the patterns of travel times between connected stops, and runs defines the start times of day when schedules are active. For the most part, you probably don't need to worry about the details of most of these tables, since the tools we have automatically convert GTFS data into this format, and the rest of our tools just consume the data as is. So don't worry too much if you didn't absorb all of this or if you feel like you're still missing something. And don't feel like you need to go and read every word in the documentation unless you're planning to create these tables from scratch. However, there is one thing you really should understand, and that's the distinction between specific dates and generic weekdays. We touched on this a bit when we were talking about GTFS datasets. When you're doing analysis, you need to decide if you want to consider public transit service available on a specific date or on a generic weekday. So, do you want to model a typical Wednesday, or do you want to model a specific Wednesday representing a holiday or a special event? The public transit data model, calendars and calendar exceptions tables are the important ones here. Calendars defines regularly repeating service on weekdays. Calendar exceptions defines exceptions to the service, such as service added or subtracted for holidays. When you do an analysis with a specific date, the regular weekday service in calendars is considered. The start and end dates in calendars are also considered, so if your date falls outside of that range, the service won't be included. Additionally, service that's added or subtracted for the date in calendar exceptions will be considered. When you do an analysis for a generic weekday, only the regular weekday service defined in calendars is considered. The date ranges in calendars and the added and subtracted service in calendar exceptions will be ignored. You need to consider your data here because not every transit dataset has data for both calendars and calendar exceptions, and this relates back to GTFS data. Some transit agencies do not provide any exceptions to regular service. If you're getting your data from GTFS, the calendar dates file might not exist, and your calendar exceptions table will be empty. In this case, it probably won't make a difference to your analysis if you use a specific date or a generic weekday because the service will be the same. Other transit agencies prefer to define all their service explicitly using exceptions rather than defining a regular service at all. In the GTFS dataset, the calendar.txt file may be missing or empty or have no service for all rows, and the main service is defined in calendar_dates.txt. This translates into the public transit data model directly. In this case, you'll get no service if you try to do all your analysis for a generic weekday, and you need to pick a specific date to get anything at all. The point here is to examine your data carefully before you do your analysis and make sure you're making the right choice. How do you get your data into the public transit data model? The GTFS to public transit data model tool, found in the public transit tools toolbox, converts GTFS public transit data into the feature classes and tables for the public transit data model. This tool does everything for you. You can put in one or more GTFS datasets, and it will do all the data checking and validation and the conversion into the public transit data model. Note that in versions of ArcGIS Pro prior to 2.9, this tool was located in the conversion tools toolbox, and it was called GTFS to Network Dataset Transit Sources. It's still the same tool, it just got moved and renamed. If your dataset has blank values for arrival time and departure time in the stoptimes.txt file, the tool can interpolate arrival and departure times from the surrounding time points if you check on the Interpolate Blank Stop Times option. This tool creates everything except the stops on streets and stop connectors feature classes in the data model. You can create those with the Connect Public Transit Data Model to Streets tool, which I'll talk about in a later video. I'd like to point out that you don't necessarily have to start from GTFS data, although this is definitely the easiest way since we've provided a tool for you. But you could manually create the feature classes and tables, or you could create your own converter script or tool from your own data model or some other standard. The documentation is thorough and lists the full schema and allowed values. If there's some other standard for public transit schedule data in your country or region and you'd like to see a converter tool built into ArcGIS Pro for it, post your suggestion to the ArcGIS Ideas site or talk to your Esri representative. Now I'll give you a demo of converting GTFS data to the public transit data model and give you a tour of the resulting tables and feature classes. Here I am in ArcGIS Pro. The Network Analyst tutorial data comes with two sampled GTFS datasets for the Cincinnati region, and I'm going to show you how to convert those into the public transit data model so that we can use them for further analysis. Now, the first thing I need to do is to create a file geodatabase where the public transit data model data will be stored. So in the catalog pane under databases, I can just right-click and say new file geodatabase. I'll just call it transit network. So my file geodatabase got created. And now I need to create a feature data set inside this geodatabase. So if I right click, I can say new feature data set. And this opens the create feature data set tool. I need to give it a name. And I also need to choose the coordinate system. Now I don't really want to use Web Mercator. That comes up as default. I guess I'll just use WGS 1984. You can choose anything appropriate for your geography and analysis needs. Okay, so if I go back to the catalog pane, you'll see that now I have this feature dataset inside my file geodatabase. This feature dataset will be used as the input to the GTFS to public transit data model tool. So the GTFS to public transit data model tool is the tool that will convert my GTFS data into the public transit data model, feature classes, and tables. First, I need to choose the GTFS folders to use, and I can pick more than one. So both the SORTA and the TANC public transit agencies provided GTFS for our network analyst tutorial data. So I'll select both of those, and it will combine the data from both of these GTFS datasets when I run the tool. I also need to pick the target feature dataset, and that will be the feature dataset that I just created in my transit network geodatabase. Now I checked my GTFS data in advance and I confirmed that there are no blank stop times in either of these datasets. If there were, I could check on this option to interpolate the blank stop times and that would just create some good estimates of the values, but I don't actually need to for this data. Append to existing tables is mostly an option where perhaps in the past I processed some data and one of the datasets out of several had a problem. And then I went back and fixed the problem, and then I just want to append the data into some existing transit data models. So that's not relevant for my case right now. So now I'll run the tool, and it will take a few moments, and I won't bore you by making you watch that. All right, the tool is finished running, and you can see I've got my transit stops and lines in the map, and it looks a little bit of a mess. The reason that there's all these straight lines for line-varying elements is probably because there's some express routes that go from downtown Cincinnati out to the suburbs without any stops in between. And the line features here are not representing the actual paths through the network that were traveled by the buses, for example, but just straight-line connections between stops. But nevertheless, this is the correct interpretation and the correct output of this tool to create the feature classes for my transit data model. So you can see that stops and line variant elements were added, as well as all of these tables. And if I look in my geodatabase that I created at the beginning of this exercise, I've got my line variant elements and stops in the feature dataset, and then all of the tables are external to the feature dataset because they can't be in a feature dataset. So I can take a look at the attribute table of some of these. Nothing terribly exciting to see here, but we've got the ID, which relates stops to the other tables, and then these fields that came from the GTFS data. Line variant elements also has some IDs and some information about the sequence and some relationships to the stops that it serves. And I won't go through all of these detailed tables, but I do want to show you calendars and calendar exceptions because of what we talked about related to exact specific dates and generic weekdays. So the calendars table, you can see there's a field for each weekday. And some of these services have ones and some of them have zeros for the different weekdays. And that indicates the days of the week that these particular service IDs are running. And there's also a start and end date. Now this data is a little bit old, so these dates are in the past, but that's not really important. But if you're using a specific date, these start and end date ranges matter. And if you choose something outside of this date range, then you won't get any service. Calendar exceptions, of course, defines exceptions to service. And you can see that there's a calendar ID field relating it to one of the IDs in calendars. And there's some information about whether service is added or subtracted on these specific dates. So it's important that you examine these and understand what regular service is available and what exceptions are available. So because I do have plenty of information here in calendars, it is valid with this data set for me to do an analysis on a generic weekday. For example, I could pick, let's say, a Thursday, and as long as I was using service from ID 3 or ID, whatever this is, 6, then I would get some service on that Thursday.